This one's called Superstar.
Last time we were here, we opened up from a, for a girl from Spain.
What was her
Sample.
Name?
Susan Sample.
Yeah, she was great, and you guys treat us great here, so thank you very much for having us back.
Hi, I'm Julian, the drummer, and I'm here in the band since 2017.
Oui.
Right? And I'm enjoying it.
Julian Mayhew, and then we got a couple local guys here.
We recognize.
Mr. Gerben Kulin and Mr. Ralph Schraven.
You have a famous song, yeah, I believe. It's called Mama.
Mama, yeah. Well,
is
actually,
it about your mother or not?
Well, well, no comment on that one.
But it's a cool song.
This one's called Mama. It goes like this. Will Mama love me? She never rocked me in the cradle. Mama love me, but Mama's love was hot. My mama was a redneck cowboy. She listened to Grammy Lou. Texas sun with the armadillo driving. Mama loved me. She never rocked me in the cradle. Mama loved me, but Mama's love was hard. Well, Mama loved me. She made me more than able. Mama loved me, but Mama's love was hard. Absolutely, yeah.
And how does a song come to you, to your mind? How does it work?
I get asked that question a lot, and there's not really one answer, you know, and I don't really know how it happens, but I try not to question it too much because I'm afraid it'll stop happening. So, yeah, that just...
What comes first, the lyrics or the music?
It's always different. Sometimes it's just one line. A phrase, sometimes it's a riff, but I would say the most important thing is always the melody of the song. Well, all of our songs
are open for a jam, you know, we can do that. But when we go in the studio, it's pretty much... And speaking of the studio, we leave in 1 week to go to Texas to record our next CD in Sugar Hill Studios in Houston, Texas, yeah.
Okay, and what is the plan after that?
To conquer the world.
Yeah. How are you going to do that?
Well, we're building a Viking ship, and we're gonna sail around and just rock and roll everywhere.
Caroline Don't Mind goes like this.
The guitarists, how can you, let's say, do it, play together? Because sometimes one goes in the left side, the other to the right side, to get it right in the mix. How does it work?
How's that work, Ralph?
Well, it has to work organically, you know? You can't force it. That's what I remember most about my first gig with these guys, as I just showed up and I said I'm gonna play the show, and it works. So it's kind of, if it works, it works. So you don't question it.
The Dolly thing, Zach.
Well, it's a T-shirt.
You don't have to explain Dolly. You know Dolly Parton, of course. Yeah, she's one of my favorite songwriters, and the T-shirt was a gift from one of my favorite bass players.
it's pretty cool.
Yeah, she was hot. She was a hottie. Yeah. Great songwriter.
Mm. The guys from Tilburg, you play in other bands?
No.
I don't at this moment. No. I played with the cameraman before in Rusty Nets, and I played with Ralph before in other bands, but now I don't have any other band as X.
And what's your story? You played before, which band did you play before?
When I was young, I used to play in a lot of bands in France, because this is where I'm from. But no, I got only two bands. It's enough. With these guys, it's a lot of work, and I really love it.
What is French connection, Zaki? What is
why France? In the year 2016, I was playing in a really small club in Galveston, Texas. And a couple came in, and I was finished for the night. I was putting my gear away, and they told me they had come all the way from France to see me. So I felt obliged to set my stuff back up and play a couple songs. And the man turned out to be my manager in France. His name's Fabrice Cat. Fine gentleman, French nobleman. But he started bringing me over to France, and we've been doing it ever since, you know.
Pretty cool. And you live
there as well? Yes, off and on. I live about half the year in the United States and half the year in France.
This was called Wounded Puzzle. And I can't make your pieces fit.